Welcome viewers. In continuation of series of IFRS 9, today our topic is derecognition of financial instruments. My name is Muhammad Shakil and we are recording this lecture at the platform of HOPE, House of Professional Education. This IFRS is applicable on single as well as consolidated financial statements. Hence, an entity first consolidate all subsidiaries in accordance with IFRS 10 and then applies this IFRS. If you are having any queries regarding this lecture, please feel free to contact us as a given email ID. An entity shall recognize a financial asset when and only when the contractual right to the cash flow from the financial assets expire or it transfer the financial asset. An entity that transfer a financial asset if and only if either it transfer the contractual right to receive the cash flow of the financial assets or retain the contractual rights to receive the cash flow of the financial assets but assume a contractual obligation to pay the cash flow of one or more recipient in an arrangement with some conditions, which are: number one, should be back-to-back arrangement; number two, prohibited by the term of the transfer contract from selling or pledging the original assets; number three, the entity has an obligation to remit any cash flow it collects on behalf of the eventually recipient without material delay. The other area is the requirement of the derecognition of financial liability. An entity shall remove a financial liability or part thereof from its statements of financial position when and only when the obligation specified in the contract is extinguished, i.e. discharged by payment to creditors or cancelled or expired. Further, an exchange between an existing borrower and lender of that instrument with substantially different terms shall be accounted for as an extinguishment of the original financial liability and the recognition of a new financial liability at fair value. Similarly, a substantial modification of a term of an existing financial liability or a part of it shall be accounted for as an extinguishment of the original financial liability and the recognition of a new financial liability at fair value. The difference between the carrying amount of the financial liability and extinguished shall be recognized as in the profit and loss account. Derecognition shall be applied in its entirety or part of a financial asset if and only if the part being considered to be derecognized meets one of the following conditions. Number one, specifically identified cash flow. For example, when an entity enters into a interest rate strip whereby the counterparty obtain a right to the interest cash flows but not principal cash flow from a debt instrument. Number two, fully proportionate pro rata share of cash flow. For example, when an entity enters in an arrangement whereby the counterparty obtains a right to a 90% share of all the cash flows of a debt instrument. But if the arrangement is to transfer the right to the first or the last 90% of cash collection from a financial asset, then the derecognition of a financial asset shall be in its entirety or not partly. Secondly, the right of 90% of cash flow from a group of receivables but provide a guarantee to compensate the buyer for any credit losses up to say 88% of the principal amount of the receivables, then also the derecognition of financial asset will be in its entirety, not partly. The third, fully proportionate pro rata share of specifically identified cash flow. For example, when an entity enters into an arrangement whereby the counterparty obtains the right to a 90% share of interest cash flows from the financial assets, transfer of a financial asset decision depends on the contractual rights to recover the cash flows. When this right has transferred to the entity, then the financial asset is supposed to be derecognized. Or if not transferred, but assume a contractual obligation to pay the cash flow to other entity, then also the financial assets is supposed to be derecognized. But in this case, we need to fulfill all the three conditions that are: it will be a back-to-back payment arrangement, cannot sell or pledge the original asset, fund transfer to the other party immediately after receipts. If the entity retain substantially all the risk and rewards of ownership of the financial assets, the entity shall continue to recognize the financial asset. If the entity neither transfer nor retain substantially all the risk and rewards of the ownership of the financial assets, the entity shall determine whether it has retained control of the financial asset. If yes, then it shall continue to recognize the financial asset to the extent to its continuing involvement in the financial asset. But if no, it shall de-recognize the financial asset and recognize separately an asset or liability, any right or obligation created or retained in the transfer. It is if a transferred asset continue to be recognized in the asset and the associated liability shall not be offset. Similarly, the entity shall not offset any income arising from the transferred asset with any expense incurred on the associated liability. Now let's see the flow chart of the derecognition. Consolidate all subsidiaries including special purpose entity. Determine whether that derecognition principles below are applied to all or part of the asset. Have the rights to the cash flows from the asset expired? Yes, then derecognize the asset. If no, then see, has the entity transferred its right to receive the cash flow from the asset? No, then has the entity assumed an obligation to pay the cash flow from the asset that meets the condition in IFRS paragraph 3.2.5? No, then continue to recognize the asset. If yes, and also yes in the previous case, then has the entity transferred substantially all the risk and reward? Yes, derecognize the asset. No, has the entity retained substantially all risk and reward? Yes, continue to recognize asset. No, has the entity retained control of assets? No, derecognize the asset. Yes, then we see continue to recognize asset to the extent of the entity continuous involvement. Viewers, this is all about regarding this topic. If you are having some better suggestion, please share with us so that we will be able to consider your valuable suggestions while recording our future lecture. Thank you.